Hi, I'm Joe Francica from CoreLogic. What is geospatial data? Well, let's start with the basics. Geo refers to a place on the Earth's surface, and spatial refers to the relationship between objects. So geospatial is the relationship and the proximity between people, places, and things on the Earth's surface. Geospatial data has both referential positioning and information about the object or place at that location. References to geospatial or location-based data are the same thing, but most people use the word location rather than geospatial. How does this fit in with location-based data? Well, let's frame the definition of location-based data this way. For most of us that deal with data and information, we work with spreadsheets. But location-based data is always accompanied with a reference to a place on the Earth's surface, and we can pinpoint that location with latitude and longitude, the most common coordinates of location. Now, as people, we are very visual in nature, so it is very helpful to be able to see what the data reveals about the location of retail stores or a potential site for your hotel on a map. If someone handed you the latitude and longitude of that store or hotel on a piece of paper, that would not be very helpful. Put a different way, you could look at reams and reams of location data in a spreadsheet or look at one map. That map view perspective helps users find these proximity relationships that would otherwise be missed in a spreadsheet. What are the where questions that geospatial data addresses or should address? We ask geospatial questions every day. It's just that we are not always aware that we are asking questions that require geospatial information. For example, a real estate developer asks, where should we place our next convenience store? Or where will the majority of my customers come from if my storefront is there? Or more specifically, where are the street intersections with the highest volume of vehicular and pedestrian traffic between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. on Wednesday in Peoria, Illinois? Now that's a where question that requires a great deal of location-based information. What determines the optimal location for a commercial business expansion? The factors that determine an optimal location for expansion into a market requires several sets of location-based data. We want to consider our target market that best describes our customers. That requires the most up-to-date demographic data to identify a trade or catchment area from which we would expect to attract customers. This could be an area that encompasses 1 mile or 3 mile or 50 miles, depending on the type of establishment, its merchandise, and many other factors. We want to know vehicular traffic data, and so we would need a provider of both digital street network data and the accompanying volume of cars that travel during certain periods of time. It may also require data on the most recent information about real estate, the accompanying rental and tax rates, and the size of the property. The location and visual appearance of that property and the accessibility to customers has tremendous importance as to the overall value of that property. These are just some of the location and attractiveness factors, but there are many more. The ability to synthesize and integrate this variety of location data to discern an answer to a business problem is how geospatial technology provides a key advantage over other enterprise solutions. What is a good example of how some companies would or could use this information? Many companies today employ location data for tasks related to site selection, such as Starbucks and McDonald's. They have teams dedicated to determining an optimal location. But there are also companies such as CSX and Union Pacific Railway that, in addition to monitoring the trains along their networks, are also heavily invested in the real estate on which these rail lines travel. Therefore, they need data related to the valuation of land, taxes, right-of-ways, and environmental concerns. And then there are the companies like FedEx and UPS, who continually monitor the cost of their vehicles as they optimize their delivery routes to minimize fuel costs while also watching out for the safety of the drivers. And finally, there are many applications related to how governments accommodate for urban expansion and economic development, from planning the location of police and fire stations to building parks and maintaining roads and highways and utility infrastructure. Geospatial technology, then, is extremely valuable to a variety of organizations, some of which have based their business models on leveraging location-based data, such as real estate, transportation, or telecommunications, or others that rely on the advantages that location solutions provide. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about how CoreLogic can help in your geospatial data journey, visit CoreLogic.com or check out the links in the description.